When I'm not working and traveling, which is a lot these days, I do really enjoy running and biking when I can down on Kelly Drive. It's really accessible. The Schuylkill River Trail is really great. I did my first triathlon in 2001, which was an effort for me after I kind of came through a really tough time with my disease, cutaneous lymphoma, to see if I could physically do something and challenge myself. And since I am a lymphoma patient, it really spoke to me with regards to combining a personal physical endeavor along with fundraising and doing something for the greater good. I'm Susan Thornton. I am a native Philadelphian and live in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. For me, when I was diagnosed back in 1991, it was a big wake-up call. And you don't expect to be diagnosed with a rare form of cancer when you think that you're young and you're vibrant and living this phenomenal life. And I had just gotten my dream job with one of the largest and most predominant healthcare software companies in the country. And I was the only woman on the sales team, and healthcare technology was just really starting to take off. I had a strange rash around my waist. It didn't go away. I went to 5 different dermatologists, and they gave me creams and lotions and potions, things like that, and it just never went away. So one day on my lunch hour, I had a friend referred me to a dermatologist that was close to our office, and I went, and she took one look at me, took my history, and said, well, I think I'm going to do a biopsy, which was the first time anybody had ever said that. And also then said, I think you have a rare form of lymphoma called mycosis fungoides. I went back to my office, grabbed all my stuff up, told our admin at the time, I've just been diagnosed with this rare form of cancer, I can't even pronounce it, and I need to go see my mom because I'm pretty freaked out about this. The roller coaster of treatment regimens is really challenging. It can take a long time, 2 to 3 months sometimes, to know whether a treatment is actually having an effect or not. I started with PUVA, which is the UVA photo treatment. When that stopped working, we tried topical nitrogen mustard. When that stopped working, I tried interferon injections. I tried targretin gel or Bexarotene tablets, which is a vitamin A derivative. And then there really wasn't anything else available at that point in time. My disease progressed from just the rash around my waist to more plaques and patches and all kind of over my body. And eventually by 1997, my disease had morphed into what they call tumor stage. So I had tumors pretty much everywhere. My scalp, my right eye was almost closed with a tumor. My face was red and scaly. And you know, there's only so much makeup you can put on to cover that. I did my best to cover everything up and to live like I was normal. But to be very honest with you, it was pretty excruciating. Those years leading up to the radiation treatments I didn't sleep for most of that time. This disease can be very itchy to the point where the only way to alleviate the itch is to scratch your skin until it bleeds. And the trauma of the emotional component is sometimes more severe to deal with than the disease or the treatment itself. The only option that was left in treatments for me by 1997 was a stem cell transplant, and which was extremely frightening, as you can imagine. Even today, it's still a very risky proposition, and at that time, we really didn't even know how well a stem cell transplant would work, but I really had run out of options. So bringing all of that together, throughout the course of the summer of 98, I was able to get through the radiation components, and by September and my 40th birthday, the disease actually had gone into remission and I didn't need the stem cell transplant. I was very, very grateful to actually be here and to have come through the process. In 2011, I was looking to do something different from my corporate career of 25 years in healthcare technology, and had the opportunity to come over to the foundation in a consulting role to do their programs and services. And here I am 5 years later as the CEO of the Cutaneous Lymphoma Foundation, which is the disease that I have and have been living with for over 25 years. And I get to support people around the world who also are diagnosed with this rare and often misdiagnosed or undiagnosed disease. For many people living with cutaneous lymphoma, there are a number of unmet needs. So sometimes it's getting to the right specialist. If you're living in an area where you don't have access to someone that really treats this disease, it's very challenging. Even though we have new treatments in cutaneous lymphoma, we still need a lot more work to be done in the area of treatments that are effective for the long term. So what I would say to the people who are developing treatments for cutaneous lymphoma is that the work that you do every day is critical to people who live with this disease. Being able to have new treatments based on new understanding of the disease that is targeted and accessible to people wherever they live, no matter what their insurance, is critical. The best part of what I do every day is actually talking to people and meeting them at our live events and knowing that what we've been able to do through the foundation has changed their life. We were in New York this past weekend, and I had a patient who came up to me. She had never met anyone else who had been diagnosed with this disease, and she's had some challenges with regards to getting to the right physician with her insurance and so forth. And she just said, I love you. Thank you so much for everything that you've been able to do for me. And she gave me a big hug, and that's why I do what I do.